Hello dear viewers, welcome to another tutorial. Actually, this is a video entitled Making of the Web Project, Project 52. And if you haven't watched the tutorial about the geometry nodes, you can check the link in the description or the link in the top right corner. Today we are going to focus mainly on the materials and the lights. I'm gonna anyway show you the finished screenshot of the geometry node setup. You can check this one here. This is the screenshot. I made it nice and big so you can take a look at it. And we are going to switch now to the shader editor. And I'm gonna show you, let's start with the world shader. The world shader is not very complicated. It just have some regular texture coordinates and of course an HDRI. If I switch to render view and if I cut this one, you should see it. Not really, because I moved the project file and the HDRI is nowhere to be found. But anyway, it's this HDRI here, downloaded from the Polyheaven. And what I did with it is I used the camera ray to separate the light and the reflections, because I wanted to have more reflections on the surface. Being a metallic surface was a must. So I'm gonna plug anyway a HDRI just to show you the reflections on the surfaces. So let's choose something, doesn't matter for this project anyway. So let's plug this one back. And that's gonna give us very nice reflection on the surface. That was the idea. So what did I do with the materials? Well, this is the dots material that we see here. It's a simple emission shader, nothing out of the ordinary, with a huge strength and value. You can go above one in the values in the color, in case you haven't find out by now. And what I did with the web, I turned it into a metallic surface with a very small roughness. You should turn on the screen space reflections and the bloom for this kind of effect. The base color, it's like you see a grayish color. So everything that you saw in the demo in the material was because of the reflections from the HDRI. That's the idea. For example, if I switch back to this one and I put this one to zero, and I also kill the lamps, you can see the material looks way different. I had the more interesting the reflection because of the HDRI that I chose anyway. What I did with the lights. Lights are important because I use this fog domain. It's a cube that it's encompassing the scene. So I did this for the fog. One thing important, if you want to see the fog in your render, it's really important. Let me switch to another frame, something like this. It's really important to have light. If you don't have light, you are not gonna see anything. You see only this blue stuff because this is the emission from the volume, but to see the actual volume you kind of need lights. That's the key to remember here. And what I did, this is a setup for the emission. I gave it this blue look that you see here. I was going for something like a soft painterly look. So I did this. I plugged this magic texture here. It has just regular coordinates, nothing special on the object. So we have the center here. And let me put this one here. When I put this magic texture with these values and I crunch this color ramp, because you get this something like this. If you want to decrease the influence of what you put here, you have to bring it very close to the end. And this is the setup that is giving us this blue streaks. And for the other one, I did something similar. I use also magic texture, but I increased the scale considerably because I wanted to have bigger scales, basically. And again, you can control the density with this color ramp, like you saw here. Just want to have a little bit of it, so this entire setup will not look like floating in the space. I use some lights and I did some coloring on them to have a color scheme. These oranges, pale oranges and blue, that was my color scheme. And also I had the sun to make sure that I'm gonna see the fog nicely, also a color sign. And an irradiance volume. Not sure it's needed for this setup, but I wanted to play with it. That's basically gonna capture your reflections. So I thought it's going to help a little bit with this dotted line on the metal shader. So basically, that's what I did in this project. Hope you find these tips useful. Thank you very much for watching. And hope to see you in the next tutorial. Until then, have a nice day and happy blending.